Welcome to Lulu's Storytime, where imagination comes to life. Get ready to dive into a world full of heartwarming tales that will capture your imagination as you drift off to sleep.
How I Saved the Ants
by Jyotsnasat Raju.
How I Saved the Ants. Long ago, there lived a boy named Chiku. He used to roam around the forest and trouble the villagers of Chikapur. Summer had just begun, the entire forest glittered and was filled with the sweet aroma of mangoes. The clock struck 7 a.m. and Granny lifted his blanket. "Get up, you lazy boy. It's time for school," Miss Elsa yelled while shaking him awake. Chiku whispered,
"Let me sleep, Granny. I'm still sleepy." Puff, puff.
Miss Elsa rushed towards the direction of the blowing kettle. Chiku stood and sprinted out, sniffing the flowers and fresh fruits. "This is it! This is it!" He jumped for joy while he loaded his bag with mangoes and relished their sweet, ripe flesh. "Chase him! Chase him!" the monkeys yelled while they watched him steal their mangoes away. Buzz! Zoom! Zap! Chiku sprinted to his hut.
"Where were you, lazy boy? What's in your bag? And what are those tiny things?" Miss Elsa yelled at Chiku, clutching her teeth. "I got it from the monkeys, Granny," Chiku whispered in a soft voice. "These are ant eggs. Go right now and put them back. Don't you know their mom will be worried?" Miss Elsa grumbled in a loud voice. "But Granny," Chiku chipped in. "No buts. Go drop it into the anthill. Now leave," Miss Elsa yelled at him.
His heart skipped a beat as he watched his granny's face. While Chiku danced and jumped on his feet, whoosh, spoink, he slipped and landed in a vast tunnel.
"Granny, Granny, please help me. I'm falling,"
Chiku cried, rubbing his eyes while he wiped his tears. "What happened to me? Where am I?" Chiku whispered to himself. "Hey, you. Yes, you. Who are you?" an ant questioned, pointing a stick at him. "Our food, our eggs are gone. He destroyed it," another ant cried loudly. An ant charged. "Let's teach him a lesson," the ants roared.
"Granny, Granny, I'm in trouble. Save me," Chiku cried as he shoved his body.
"What's all the commotion?" "Who is there?" questioned the queen to her guards. She sprinted in the direction where Chiku stood and instructed the ants to stitch him back. "I'm sorry, my child. We are good ants, and we don't harm others unnecessarily." The queen apologized and pulled a magic wand. Whoosh, swoosh. She sprinkled her magical glitter, telling him he can be both ant and human whenever he wanted, with a spell. "Ants are cool. Ants are brave. If they can do it, I can too." Chiku stayed in the anthill for a few days. Whoosh, whoosh. The trees and wind howled. Chiku twisted, swirled, and swayed into the hole while carrying food, his head stuck in a huge pot. The queen requested her guard to remove it. Zap, bang. The queen and the guard hammered and it slipped, fell, and broke. Whoosh, whoosh. The trees rustled while Chiku and the ants went to a nearby forest. Mud, water. "Everyone stay calm," the queen requested. The ants scrambled around the mud and drifted in rain.
"We are our heroes. Follow me," Chiku instructed the ants. "Ants are cool. Ants are brave. If they can do it, I can too,"
the ants chanted as they walked. The ants followed Chiku safely and swam in the muddy rain, Klitsch clutching the wood on the way. "Up and down, big and small. We can do it. Yes, we did it," the ant sang, jumped, and danced.
"Oh no,
What's wrong with our anthill? Chiku said as his heart reached his mouth, while he noticed his friends had sunk in the muddy puddle. Chiku's eyes flashed through a juicy banana leaf. Oh gosh, there's a big caterpillar on it. Ants are cool, ants are brave. If they can do it, I can too, the ants chanted. A few hours passed, and he neared the caterpillar. His face watered and shivered. Mr. Fatso Caterpillar, can you lend me the leaf? We need it, requested Chiku. No, no, go away. This is mine, Mr. Fatso yelled. A butterfly who watched them flew towards him and said, My dear, we should always help each other. Give it to them. Up and down, big and small, we can do it. Yes, we did it. The ants hummed and rejoiced. The sun shone and the forest bloomed. Help us! Help us! That monster is eating our eggs, cried the ants. Chiku woke up to the cries of the ants and rushed in the direction of the ant queen. What's the matter? Why are you sad? Questioned Chiku. That huge anteater destroyed our anthill and stole our eggs, cried the ants and rushed towards Chiku. We need to teach it a lesson, Chiku murmured and clutched his hands. The next morning, the anteater entered the anthill and the ants attacked it with all their strength. Later, Chiku also helped them with his power. The anteater wept and vanished. Up and down, big and small, we can do it. Yes, we did it! The ants clapped and danced in joy. After a few days, Chiku returned the eggs and left for his hut. On the way, he whispered, Ants are cool. Ants are brave. If they can do it, I can too. On reaching his house, Chiku narrated everything to his grandma and became an obedient child who started going to school. He taught his friends to be like an ant in every situation. Later, he spread the message in his village. Whoever comes across ants, they should never harm them and they should feed them with jaggery.
Come back to Lulu's for more story time.